So the engine just stopped working and it seems we ran out of gasoline.
And the turtle, it's amazing that you find a turtle right here. Okay! Did you get some fresh caught fish?
No, instead of offering me fish, they offered me yaki. But I said, when I start drinking yaki, I will finish the bottle. And then they said, yeah, come on.
I am Rihanna.
And I am Sherman.
And this is our son, Benjamin.
2020 has been a year of adventures and challenges.
We drove all the way from Amsterdam to Didim, Turkey to get to our sailing home.
We did a total refit and now we can finally start sailing around the world while setting up and expanding our businesses.
Join our adventures and welcome on board.
Now a quarter before 2 in the middle of the night, and I think half an hour ago.
Yeah,
half an hour ago we woke up because there was an alarm, and it's the bilge water alarm. So we're making water. It's in the engine room, we know. It's like how much centimeters?
7 centimeters of water, salt water. Yeah, I just pumped out 25 liters. There's still 2 centimeters left.
So we're trying to figure out what it is right now. We had it before that there was water in the engine room because of the bearing of the...
of the shaft.
Of the shaft was leaking, but they fixed that. So it shouldn't be leaking anymore. And we never had this much in this short period of time. So we're trying to figure out what it is. And then we have to make a decision. Or we stay here, wait till the next day. Or we go to the marina. Or we call the Coast Guard. But I can show a little bit of the water. I don't know if I can show it to you right now, but Gerben already pumped out quite a bit. Can't tell you much more than that this kind of sucks. Okay, we tested the water again, and it's not salt water, seawater. It's sweet water, and we found a whole lot of water inside the boat, and this is going to the engine room and from the engine room to the bilge. But sweet water, only thing that we can imagine what we've done, we had the water maker on, washer first, so I'm gonna empty this first now. So we have a couple of options left, and that's that maybe one of the water pipelines is leaking, or that something got loose. We're taking out all the water together. Yeah, hopefully it stops, but at least we're not sinking. It's sweet water, not salt water, so the worst part that could happen is that all the water tanks empty up. The bilge pump and our manual pump can handle that, so nothing very seriously dangerous. So we're staying here and tomorrow to the harbor, to the marina, to fix everything.
Yes.
So we slept okay, and it's probably the shower at the up deck with the swimming pool that was causing the leaking. There's no more water since we turned off the water pressure. Gerber kept watch the whole night, and now it's morning, so we're ready to go to the marina. Yeah, it's a little bit windy. It looks like there's some bad weather coming.
Copy that. Please stand by at the entrance of the marina. We will send our pilot boat. They will help you as soon as possible. The marina.
Thank you very much for your service. See you later. Good night, then. Next to catamaran. So I'm going to check in the marina office here in Turgutreis to get some proper Wi-Fi and some electricity, so Rihanna can work. I can hang around with Benjamin a bit and thinking about the possibilities where the leakage can come from. We are part of the Beneteau 57 owners group on Facebook. Last night I posted a message over there. Some very helpful insights came, and or it could be the water maker, or it could be the hose running to the shower. Oh, hi, good night. In. I'm good. I'm on my way to you.
Wi-Fi passport for you.
Wow.
Also, you can find here the map of the marina.
Okay. Fantastic.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Super. See you later. I come to the office.
Of course.
Yes.
See you.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Wow, this is what you call service. You don't have to go to the marina office and we get everything here. Thank you so much. Benjamin is asleep. And we have some more water underneath our bed. So there's one compartment, it's full with water, fresh water luckily. So we opened here. So I put in the Beneteau 57 owners group and they told me because some hoses, maybe they're leaking from the shower at the back. So I'm checking everything, but everything is dry over here. So now we know that the water is here and the water is on a higher level than in the engine room. So it should come from the aft. So let's check the aft and let's see if we can find the solution there. So this is at the lazarette. Here is the is our master cabin. And here we have the shower hose. Ah! I think I found the problem. So what happened? Benjamin played here with the shower. And he opened up the hose and he switched to get water. So, and it was leaking behind the wall inside the boat, and I think it's more than 100 liters. So we found the problem. So pumping begin.
Trevor's gonna vacuum clean all the water outside the build, you know, outside the engine room. And we found out that it wasn't totally and only Benjamin's fault that we were making water. There was also some salty water, and that was because the generator was leaking water as well. And that's fixed now, so we can now finally take all the water out. Sailing today. Looking forward to it. We're gonna leave the marina for a couple of days, but we will come back. We have some things to arrange. The second autopilot, the old autopilot, still needs to be fixed. Yeah, so that's it. So for now, just enjoying life and going for a sail, doing some office work in a beautiful bay, and playing around with the family.
Day Marine, this is setting up perfect tense. If there is wind, we sail.
Okay.
Bye, lekker slapen. So we're sailing now. Just left Turgutreis. We're going to Djokovac Bay. It's just around the corner of Bodrum. Just today, 70 nautical miles. But the interesting thing is, we are heading now to Kos in Greece. But let's see what will happen, because we have the radio standby. It's a good course now for sailing and to make a tack. But the interesting is that there are no boats allowed from Turkey to Greece. I think they will call us on the radio and say, okay, we have to turn. Because the next phase, what we're gonna do is, when we want to enter Greece, we only can transit. So that means that we can only pass Greece. We can't stop, we are not allowed to drop anchor. Or go on land, and that's a long journey towards Montenegro. It will take us, let's say, a day or five. So it's interesting, but it's such a good feeling to sail again. The moment when you switch off the engine, that's the most beautiful part, because then it's peace and tranquility. The interesting thing is that Benjamin wants to go to bed. Every time we start sailing, Benjamin wants to go to bed. First he wants to help, and then he wants to go to bed, so that's good. So we crossed the border with Greece, but nothing happened. So we didn't got a call on the VHF. Benjamin is asleep, so it's time for some lunch. And I think Jan is cooking at the moment. Are you cooking?
Yes.
Spaghetti bolognese?
No, I think with pesto and rucola. I don't know if you call it rucola, for me it's called differently, but it doesn't matter. And some cherry tomatoes.
Cool. Do you like your new view?
Yeah, I love it. But this isn't totally fair, because it's not always like this sailing and cooking. Most of the times it's like...
This is champagne sailing.
This is champagne sailing. But that's also a big part of sailing in the Med, champagne sailing.
Yeah. So we had a wonderful sail here into Djokovac Bay, and we are now approaching an uninhabited island. You can see it here. It's over there. We have a lighthouse on it, surrounded by rocks. I'm gonna take away the Genoa to go slowly just around the island and approach it and look for a beautiful anchorage. So just check the anchorage, it's beautiful over here, but there are lots of rocks and the wind is gonna change, so we are going a little bit deeper inside the bay here, but it's beautiful.
The internet isn't working anymore here in the bay. That's sailing life as well. Doing business on a sailing boat isn't easy. So we have to sail a little bit.
Benjamin and I go on a dinghy stroll and gonna see what's going on here.